This video is going to cover a new tool that we're going to start utilizing. It's called the Event Point List. It will help with our cross sections. It's got a multitude of uses, but for this example, I'm going to show you how you can use it in your cross sections. Okay, so the first thing is what an event point list is. It's a list that you can create of stations and offsets if you wanted station offset along your alignment, that you can use this list later on to create cross sections. So if you had cross sections you were cutting even station for most part, and then you had a couple of spots that you wanted to cover, you know, for anything really, you would be able to put a station there, an event point list, a point there, and use it. So I'm just gonna go ahead and show you. You have to do this in your civil geometry file. So I'm in the civil geometry file. It applies it to the alignment and it sticks with the alignment. So wherever you go, whatever file, you'll be able to see that event point list. So it's located under the geometry tab, and it's located out here. There are common tools, and it's the one pointing to the event point list. Okay, so when you select it, it's going to ask you on your cursor to locate the alignment. So I'm going to come down and pick the alignment. And when you do that, the very first time you do it, it's going to give you an option to include horizontal cardinal points and vertical cardinal points. Now, I wouldn't suggest doing them in here because you can do the horizontal cardinal points in the tool. But if you wanted to see these vertical cardinal points, you could add them in. In this example, I'm going to leave them both out. I don't think I want all those cross sections, so I'm going to say no and accept it by left clicking in a blank area to the horizontal, and then left clicking to say no on the verticals. Okay, when you do that, it's going to bring up a dialog. Okay, and in this dialog is where it stores all the points that we're going to place out here. The first thing is it takes it off the feature definition, okay, the name of it. You can add to the list if you wanted to with another list. You could delete the list. You can rename the list. And I'm going to do that for this one because I'm working with Route 54. So I'm going to select Rename List. And I'm going to call this one Route 54. And hit OK. Okay, so now I've got that in there. There's a couple other icons after that on this dialog. One is Add by Station Offset. That's the one I'm going to use. But there's some more. There's a Add by Northing and Easting. If you wanted to do that, you could. There's also Add Horizontal Cardinal Points. So if you didn't pick it up before and you wanted to come back and do it, you can always do it with this tool here. And then there's the Add Vertical Cardinal Points as well. So you can add them that way as well. And there's always where you can delete a point that you placed in here that you don't really want. So let's get to adding some points in here. The way you do it is you go to the Add by Station, and that's the way I'm going to do it for the cross sections. This is just specifically for cross section use only is what I'm doing. You could have, you know, 50 to 100,000 points out there, whatever, and you could select them in a selection set and bring them in at once. You could do that and use those points, and it would give you the station offset from that alignment if you had a bunch of points out there. But that's not what I'm using this tool for at the moment. I'm going to use it just for showing how we can create cross sections using an event point list, which keeps us from having to draw pattern lines throughout your files. Okay, so I'm going to go to this tool, Add by Station Offset. It comes up and it's dynamic the first time you do it. After that, it's going to be locked into whatever you click on. And I'm going to go to about, let's go down here about, I'll try doing like 625, 630 or something like that. I'll put some numbers in here. So this one looks like a good one. I'm going to arbitrarily pick a point because I want it to be an oddball station. So I'm going to say 626, 1915, region 2. It's region 2 because we're in a station equation on this alignment. This is the Road 1 project that we're using, and it does have a station equation. So I'm going to go ahead and left click to accept that. And it's going to place me a point right there. And the thing it does is it picks up the offset, and I don't want an offset for this. I want to make this 0. So I'll come in here, hit 0, hit the Enter key, and lock that in. So now I have an event point at this 626.19.15, region 2. And I could place as many more as I need for this alignment. So if I've got a culvert that's perpendicular off of this thing and I want to use that station where it's at, I could place this event point out there and use that for that station. I'll add one or two more. Let's see here. So we'll go back to the tool. And again, I'll dynamically place it. I'm going to say 626. What is that? 6447? That looks like a good one. So, and to show you that it will reorder them, I'll pick another point, but I'll go before that 625 and I'll pick one out here. When I do that, it pops it to the beginning. But you also see that it gives us the offset wherever we clicked. Now, if you hit the enter key on that, hit the enter key to set your value. Oh no, didn't like that at all. Let's try it again. Zero. Okay. if you're out here and you're placing these points and you hit the enter key to lock that value in, like if you type one in that you want, it's gonna retain those offsets in that stationing. It'll be locked in, so you can use your end key to unlock it and move it around. Okay, so I've got 3 points out here, and I really would like to take a screenshot of this, so I'm going to use my snippet tool. Since I'm using Snagit to record my video, so I wanted to see my value, so I went ahead and copied this down. These values are important. You'll know what they are because you're wanting to place them in very specific spots, but for this demonstration, I just arbitrarily threw some points out there, and I want to make sure that I get the right values. Now, with this event point list, once you've created it and you close it, it's stuck. You got it. I mean, that's the way it is. It saves it. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to close this out. Now, the other caveat about doing an event point is that when you go to create cross sections, if it's not on a template drop, you will get your ground to not seek ground. It will be off. So I'm going to show you, I'm going to create a new cross-section file, and I'm going to show you how this works. So I'm going to do a real quick new file, and I'm going to use it as a container file, which I've been going out to the districts trying to get that out and information on how to do that. And I'll call it named boundary underscore J. And I'll go underscore and I'll say route 54 and I'll do an underscore excess for cross section. So that's kind of what I'm going to name this. And I'll hit OK and open up the brand new blank file. Now, it being a container file, it allows me to do the live nesting and bring in everything that pertains to the project. So that's kind of a nice way to do it. So here's my blank file. I can go up to my reference icon, and I'm using the quick tools right here. This quick tool, and I hit the reference dialog, and I've got to grab it off the other screen, bring it over, and I'm going to do a tools attach. Using the live nesting allows me to bring across this corridors for Route 54, which I want to do. We'll verify I'm in the right folder. Yeah, it looks like I am. Okay. I'm going to hit add, and then I'm going to hit OK. So here comes my corridors file, but I want to change my nested depth, nested attachments to live nesting, and my depth to 1. Always 1, never more than 1. And then I'll hit OK. And what that's going to do is that's going to bring up, it's going to bring anything that was attached or created that corridors file in this file with it. So if I do a fit view, you can see that I've got a lot more than what I bargained for. I just brought in the corridors, but I also got my terrain, my land boundaries. I've got everything that ramp 4, I've got that as well. And you can see that when you open up the hierarchy. This demonstration is not to go over all this live nesting, but just to reaffirm what's going on here is you can turn on and off stuff just by going to the corridors, the one that you referenced in, and all this stuff you could turn on and off. You can see super elevations off because it's gray over here in the hierarchy. hierarchy button gets you there, and I've got videos on this as well. So I'm going to close this out. I've got everything I need, but anytime you create a cross-section, you have to have both views open. So I'm going to hit the F6 key and load up my, and you can see that I did not make my surface active. So if you see that happen where you open up view 2 after hitting F6 and it's the same default view, just go ahead and make that surface active. And when you set it active, and then you hit F6, you'll get your 3D model. And you can see in there we got our 3D model. We also have, you can see our right-of-way lines in there, all that good stuff. Okay, so let's go ahead and get these name boundaries out there. Okay, so I'll go to my drawing production tab. I'll go to the name boundary tool. I'll select it. It defaults to the plan. We're going to create cross section, so I'm going to go to civil cross section. I'm going to change that drawing seed. I'm going to go to 10 scale on this. And after you do that, you need to come down and read this status bar. It tells us down here that we need to identify the path, meaning we need to pick that route 54 alignment. And I can hover over it and see it's route 54. It has an active profile, route 54 proposed. That's what I want. So I'm going to select it. Now for this, I'm just going to bring in those event points. So you could make the start and stop location wherever you want. So I'm going to say start at the beginning. Start at the beginning. And you can see it's rubber band off my cursor with all these name boundaries. And I'm going to go to the end. So it's got all these. But before I accept it, I'm going to change some stuff. I'm going to leave the intervals at 50. You know, it doesn't matter. I'm going to come down here at the bottom. Everything else looks really good with the default numbers. And there's this event point list. And you notice that because I made that for Route 54, I have that option because Route 54 is in here. If I made one for Ramp 4, I would get that option as well. So we're going to pick that Route 54. And then the next thing that you'll want to do is do include event points only. Now, if you're creating your cross sections for the first time and you've got it figured out, you've got the event points where you want them, and you got your the other cross sections that you want at even stations every 100 feet or whatever you're doing, then it's fine. Leave this unchecked and process them all at once. But if you've already created cross sections, you come back and you want to add these event points, you can do event point only. The other thing is change the group to match the group that you've already created. So if you created a Route 54 as an example, then come back and change this to Route 54 and it'll add. And then you'd want to do this part, include event points only if you've already created them. Okay. And there's the include control points, which will include the horizontal control points. Okay. So once I have that selected, it's pretty close to where I want it. I can hover over or go out on my screen. And I can see there's the three event points that I created, okay, that I put out here. And it's perpendicular and it's perfect with the size of the cross section that we want. So it picks that up pretty nice. The next thing I want to do is do a create drawing. And then I want to show the dialogue, because if you skip the dialogue, you might miss annotating stuff. So now I'm going to go out in a blank area. I'm going to accept it one time. Let's see what we got over here in the 3D model. You can see where I'm cutting some cross sections right through here. And then it gives me my next dialogue. In this next dialogue, really the only thing you really want to do is change your annotation group. So I'm going to change this to cross section, drawing, and I'll do major grid only. And once that's picked up, I mean, if you had a sheet index, you can add it to there at this point in time as well. But for this demonstration, I'm just going to hit OK and open up the models that it creates. I'm going to go to that last sheet model, so it shouldn't take too long with three of these. Okay, so it came out to the last model. I'm going to go into the second model. The first model looks like it was off a little bit, so I'm going to look at the second model, see where we're at with the ground. You can see, you come in here, it looks pretty good. I guarantee it ain't on, but it looks pretty good. It looks pretty good over here. Well, you can see it's short here. Okay, so it's short. And if I go to the next model, that other one, look at it, you can probably see the same thing, that it's off a little bit here. Left side's looking pretty good, but it's not on. And then the right side, again, it's a little short. Okay, so we have to go back and fix some stuff. So here's the first sheet. This all looks pretty good, but we need to fix where we put those event points and how it's gonna work. So I'm gonna go ahead and open up the corridors file. And that's where you'll be able to fix this, because what'll have to happen is you're gonna need, wherever that event point is you're gonna wanna put a key station, which is pretty simple. It's not too difficult to do that. So I get into my corridors file, and then I go to my corridor for Route 54, and I'm gonna go out to the hammer tool. And I'm gonna go down to the key, and that's our key station. And so what we wanna do is, we want a template drop wherever we added one of those event points. So my first one was 624 plus 80.93.93. And again, that's a region 2. We wanna make sure we put that in there. Hit the enter key, it's on my cursor. I go ahead and left click, and it processes and puts that winner. And then it's ready for the second one, which was a 626 plus 19.15. And that's a region 2. Hit the enter key, lock that in, and left click and place that in there. Let it process. And then I'll come back to my tool, and I got one more to put in, which is that 626. Plus 6447.47 space R2. Lock that in. Go ahead and left click and place that third one in there. So what I've done is made that event point have a template drop in that area, and you can go look at these. You can see where I put that in. It dropped a template drop in here. So we're good now that when we go back to our file, we go back to our name boundary file that we created, and we look at what's going on in there. Because these cross sections are dynamic, you'll see the ground will now solve correctly. You won't have any gaps. And when I get in here, we're at a sheet. Let's change it over to a drawing model, and let's try this second last one. It looked good on the left side, but the right side you can see is now tied all the way, so we're good on that. Okay. And it's got an elevation offset number. The only thing I'd want to verify is the annotation doesn't update. So we may have to do some, let's do a drawing production model annotation and remove all the drawing model annotations. I'll do it for all of them. Say yes and get rid of it. And then I'll go back to the drawing model annotation tool and pick annotate drawing model. Do all the drawing models, and I want to pick the one with the major grid only is again. So I'll go back to major grid only, pick it, then I'll accept it with a left click in the blank area and left click the excess annotation with major grid only and let it process, and then it will reflect. It was really close, but it picked up where that point stopped before, but now we're dead on. So everything's updated and it's good to go. So that it's a pretty cool tool. We're just now looking at it. Let's see, I can't get the left side because it's off the needed the 20 scale there. But you can see now that we went in and put those key stations in, you get it to tie to ground, and that's what we want. So that's the event point list.